Hello, welcome to Module 1, Understanding Pregnancy-Related and Maternal Mortality Indicators. This is the first of 5 modules in the e-learning course on measuring pregnancy-related and maternal mortality from census. This module is organized into 2 episodes. In this episode, we will discuss definitions of pregnancy-related and maternal mortality. In the next episode, we will cover measures of pregnancy-related and maternal mortality. Episode 1. Definitions. In this episode, we will discuss the definitions of pregnancy-related and maternal mortality as defined by the International Classification of Diseases. In this episode, we will first discuss the definitions of pregnancy-related and maternal deaths. When most people think about pregnancy-related or maternal mortality, they think about deaths from causes directly related to obstetric complications from pregnancy. However, you will see that the WHO definition of pregnancy-related and maternal mortality is tied to the timing of deaths rather than the direct cause. You will also hear us distinguish between pregnancy-related and maternal deaths. This is because pregnancy-related and maternal deaths have different definitions under ICD-11. By the end of this episode, you will understand how pregnancy-related and maternal mortality are different. Next, we will define direct versus indirect maternal deaths. We will end this episode with a learning assessment. So let's get to the definitions. Under the ICD-11, pregnancy-related death is defined as the death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. A termination of pregnancy can include birth, abortion, or miscarriage. Note that there is no mention of cause of death here. Pregnancy-related death is based purely on the timing of death relative to pregnancy. On the other hand, maternal death is defined as the death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. Irrespective of the duration and the site of the pregnancy, from any cause related to or aggravated by the pregnancy or its management, but not from incidental or accidental causes. You can think about the difference between maternal and pregnancy-related death in this way. The big gray circle is all female deaths. A portion of that will be pregnancy-related death in the orange. This is defined by the timing of death relative to pregnancy, that is, while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. A subset of the pregnancy-related deaths will be maternal deaths. Maternal death is defined by timing of death relative to pregnancy and cause of death, namely, that it is not due to accidents or incidental causes. Maternal deaths can be further categorized into direct and indirect maternal deaths. Direct maternal deaths are deaths due to obstetric complications of pregnancy, including delivery and 42 days postpartum. Some examples of direct maternal deaths include hemorrhage, eclampsia, and sepsis. Indirect maternal deaths are deaths due to other diseases or conditions when aggravated by the physiological effects of pregnancy. These include malaria and HIV. You may be surprised to see diseases like malaria and HIV that do not seem to be directly related to pregnancy classified as maternal deaths. This is because these diseases may be aggravated by the physiological effects of pregnancy leading to deaths. While deaths from malaria or HIV may not be due to obstetric complications of pregnancy, because they have the potential to aggravate, we consider deaths from these diseases as indirect maternal deaths if they occur during pregnancy or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. Now we have a knowledge check. For each of the following scenarios, please state whether the death is pregnancy-related or maternal. A woman dies from eclampsia after giving birth. Is this pregnancy-related or a maternal death? If you said maternal, you are correct. Further, this is a direct maternal death because the death was due to obstetric complications of pregnancy. Let's take a look at the next scenario. A woman dies 1 month after delivery from cancer. Is this a pregnancy-related or maternal death? If you said maternal death, you are correct. This is an indirect maternal death because the woman died due to another disease aggravated by the physiological effects of pregnancy. Let's take a look at another scenario. A pregnant woman dies in a car accident on her way to the hospital to deliver a baby. Is this a pregnancy-related death or a maternal death? If you said pregnancy-related, you are correct. Remember, pregnancy-related death is defined as the death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy, irrespective of the causal death. In this case, the woman was pregnant when she died. That she died of a car accident is not relevant to the definition of pregnancy-related death. Because accidental deaths are excluded from maternal deaths, this is not a maternal death. The next scenario is a woman dies one day after delivery. Is this pregnancy-related or a maternal death? The answer is pregnancy-related death. In this case, we do not know the cause of her death. Since we cannot rule out accidental or incidental cause of death, the death can only be classified as a pregnancy-related death. Now let's look at another scenario. A woman dies 3 months after delivery from complications related to her cesarean operation. Is this pregnancy-related or a maternal death? The answer is neither. 3 months is beyond the time frame for both pregnancy-related and maternal death definition. Although the woman died from complications related to her cesarean operation, her death would not be classified as a pregnancy-related or a maternal death because it is outside of the 42-day time frame. This concludes the knowledge check. If you still have some questions about whether a death is pregnancy-related or maternal, be sure to look back at the slides for the definitions. In this episode, we discussed the ICD-11 definitions of pregnancy-related and maternal death. In summary, maternal death is more specific. Identifying maternal death requires some cause of death information because we need to exclude accidental and incidental deaths. Most surveys and censuses only ask about the timing of death relative to pregnancy. When cause of death is not available, or when we cannot exclude accidental and incidental deaths, we can only measure pregnancy-related deaths. In the next episode, we will discuss the various indicators used to measure pregnancy-related and maternal mortality.